Dear friends, good evening. I welcome you all, and today is the feast of Prophet Elisha. Happy feast of Prophet Elisha to all. So we are ascending Mount Carmel, and he is the one of the forefather of Mount Carmel. After Prophet Elijah, he is the successor to Mount Carmel, and the sons of the prophets who followed the steps of Prophet Elijah. So that is like one of the very first, very earliest form of religious life, the seeds of religious life we can see in the Bible, and that took the inspiration for the Carmelites. So we especially remember Prophet Elisha. We especially ask for his intercession, for his kindness, for the miracles he did, and for the strength he had, and for the zealous, fiery nature that he had. And we remember everything as we walk in this pilgrimage. We will have some scripture, and then we will have some intercessions. May God bless you all. Amen. Scripture taken from Romans chapter 8, verses 28 to 30. We are well assured that everything helps to secure the good of those who love God, those whom he has called in fulfillment of his design. All those who from the first were known to him, he has destined from the first to be molded into the image of his Son, who is thus to become the eldest born among many brethren. So predestined he called them, so called he justified them, so justified he glorified them. Our response three: the Lord is good, he loves good deeds. Please repeat: the Lord is good, he loves good deeds. His face is turned towards the upright man. The Lord is good, he loves good deeds. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. The Lord is good, he loves good deeds. Dear friends, we have seen that we are well assured. God is giving us a promise, as an assurance, a promise. Only a person who can be trusted, who is ever faithful, who is ever kind, who never breaks his promises, can give us an assurance. And here we see God giving us an assurance. Assurance that everything helps to secure the good of those who love God. So God can make everything that happens in our life, whether it's good or whether it is bad, and everything should be made as favorable for our good. God can make that. He has got that power. Often the times we may forget to acknowledge that divine supreme power, the power who can turn even the things which seems like evil to good. Often it is said that God allows evil for a very greater good. So God has got extreme power, and we are called to trust in that power. And if you see Prophet Elisha, he trusted in the power of God. And everything in his life was made by God in a way that it suited the glory of God through his servant, Prophet Elisha, as his faithful servant, as his faithful instrument. So the greatness that God had bestowed on Prophet Elisha, whether he had resurrected the dead child, or whether he performed any other miracles, and what a great authority he also possessed over the kings. And we could see all these things because God was with him, and he trusted that God can change everything in favor of him. So let us also trust that Almighty God, the times in which trusting God is quite difficult, like ascending this mountain, it's quite steep, It may become a little difficult, but even at that time, God is calling us to trust Him unconditionally and to trust in His power. So keeping this in mind, let us proceed further with some intercessions. Let us ask the Father to lead us to holiness through the intercession and example of the saints, especially Prophet Elijah. Make us holy as you are holy. Father, it was your will that we be called your children, and that is what we are. May your church all over the world bear witness to your goodness. Father, you have called us to walk in your light and do always the things that please you. May our lives be rich in every kind of good work. Father, through Christ, you have reconciled us to yourself. Keep us in your name, that we may all be one. Father, you have invited us to the festival of eternal life. Make us perfect in your love through the bread that comes from heaven. Father, grant all sinners peace and forgiveness. Let the dead live in the light of your presence. Dear Lord, we are very happy. We are thankful for giving the gift of Prophet Elijah, especially our father, because of him that we are here, because of our ancient forefathers who had kept their commandments of God very closely, that we are here as we are remembering Prophet Elijah. Lord, give us the strength to continue more and more works for your sake in this Garden of Carmel. We pray, make us holy as you are holy. Lord, often the times, holiness is a difficulty, it's a struggle. Often the structures of sin, they are very much embedded in our souls or in our bodies because of various reasons. Lord, through your power, through the intercession of Prophet Elijah, we pray that we be made holy as you are holy. For this we pray, Lord, make us holy as you are holy. We remember all the friars who lived in this monastery. We just go to their common vault or their common tomb over here. We are seeing this common tomb of the Carmelites, in which all the Carmelite fathers were buried. We especially now pray that the good Lord will grant us all mercies, all strength. We remember, as we are seeing this grave, we are remembering all our ancient fathers. We remember Prophet Elisha and his sons of prophets. We pray for all those sons of prophets, for their souls, as well as these sons of prophets who came to India to spread the word of Carmel and to love God. We pray for them. We say, make us holy as you are holy. Now, with God's strength, God's Spirit, we will invoke the Spirit of God. Come, Holy Spirit, welcome, Spirit. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, dear Father, for this wonderful moment at the sight of the Carmelites, this first sight of the Carmelites. Lord, we remember, as we are remembering, as we are celebrating the feast of Prophet Elisha today, who is our spiritual ancestor, who is our spiritual father, the successor to our spiritual father, Prophet Elijah. The same way we are remembering these fathers who have built this church and convent in Old Goa, the Carmelite fathers from the Italian congregation of the Discalced Carmelites. We especially offer them, Lord, to your hands. We remember Prophet Elijah and his deeds. May that same spirit of Prophet Elisha be poured in our hearts. May that same spirit may given to us. May all these Carmelite fathers who had given their lives for Christ by living a life of prayer, penance, silence, mortification and strength, may it continuously strengthen us, may it continuously inspire us, Lord. We also pray for the people with all who are all their needs, and the people who are attending this live prayer session now also, Lord, we especially pray for them, for their families, that the Lord may pour kind graces and great graces upon them. May they work for the Lord zealously like Prophet Elisha of Mount Carmel. Lord, be kindly with us and lead us in the path of this world, that we may become more and more closer towards Lord Jesus Christ. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen. We'll just go to the cross and we will say the prayers. The final prayer we pray. Give us grace, Lord, amid the changing scenes of this life, to set our hearts firmly on the things of heaven. Even as you gave us an example of the perfect life of the gospel through your prophet Elisha, we make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns within the unity of God the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Now we say the prayer to Blessed Dennis and Redemptus, our martyrs who lived over here, the sons of Prophet Elisha. We now say their prayers. Father, we celebrate the memory of Blessed Dionysius and Blessed Redemptus, who died for their faithful witnessing to Christ. Give us the strength to follow their example, loyal and faithful to the end. If it be your will, may they be proclaimed by the universal church as saints, living now in your presence and interceding for us all. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends, this is a prophet, this is a feast of Prophet Elijah. Elijah, like in 1399, the general of the Carmelites, they have decided to set this feast in their order. But now it has become an optional memorial for the Carmelites. They may, if they wish, they can celebrate. And we are especially remembering here this for this place of the Carmelite Church, the first Carmelite Church in India. This is the cradle of the Carmelites, of the all the Carmelites in whole of India. This is the cradle. This is the place where the Carmelites first came. The first Mount Carmel of old of India, which is located in Old Goa, filled with grace. Even though amidst it is now nature has taken most of its part, it is still having its graces because two martyrs, Blessed Dennis and Redemptus, we just said the prayers, they have lived over here. So we just now go for a small procession within this monastery, singing Salve Regina to Our Lady. It's Our Lady of Mount Carmel. We will sing. Salve Regina, Mater misericordiae, vita dulcedo, et spes nostra salve. Ad eclamamus, exules filii eve, ad suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in ac lacrimarum vale. Ea ego advocata nostra, illos tuos misericordes oculos, ad nos converte, Et esum benedictum fructum ventris tui, nobis post hoc exilium, o sante, o clemens, o pia, o dulcis Virgo Maria. Dear friends, thank you for participating in this prayer. Again, happy feast of Prophet Elisha. May Prophet Elisha completely bless you and give you all the graces. May Our Lady of Mount Carmel be forever blessed and glorified. Have a prayerful and wonderful, meaningful, prayerful evening in the silence of Carmel. May God bless you all. Amen.